Hello, anatomists and physiologists. Michelle Glass here, and welcome to our first video series over Chapter 1. So we are using the OpenStax Anatomy and Physiology free textbook this semester, and you can find links to that in your D2L course, and I've linked to that in the description of the video, so make sure you check that out. Reading the text is an important part of helping you to understand and retain the information. So some of you will like to read the chapter before you watch the videos, and others will like to read the chapter after you watch the videos. So you want to sort of play around with that and see what works best for you. When watching the videos, make sure you're in a distraction-free zone. You may want to have a pair of headphones of some type to really help you focus in. You will have closed captioning on the video, so that can help as well. And then you need a notebook and something to write with so that you can take notes. Now, some of you will like to do that on a separate device. So if you have a tablet style device where you can make handwritten notations, go that way. If you want to do pencil and paper, go that way. Remember, especially as our learning becomes more and more virtual, sometimes it's good to take a break from the electronics. And so that's where paper notebook can be super handy. Okay, so check your environment, grab your headphones, grab your notebook, and let's get started. Okay, so our very first video is all about the organization of the human body. And to begin with this conversation, we want to really begin by thinking about, okay, what do we mean by the terms anatomy and what do we mean by the terms physiology? So when we talk about anatomy, what we're really talking about is the appearance of the structure. Right? So we're really thinking about body structures here when we think about our term anatomy. So this is, you know, what are those structures? What do they look like? Where are they located? All of that sort of conversation. Now we can study anatomy at the gross level. And here, gross does not mean like icky, yucky. It means big or macroscopic. So the macroscopic level would be what we can see with our naked eye. We can also study anatomy at the microscopic level. And so, of course, these are structures that we need a microscope to help us investigate a little bit more fully. So for us in this course, we're going to be talking about structures called organelles. We're going to be talking about cells. And we're going to be talking about tissues. So these would be our microscopic levels of anatomy instruction. Now you can also study the body. There's two sort of different methods. So you can do what's called regional anatomy. So with the regional anatomy, this is like, what are the organs located together in the thoracic cavity? How do they interrelate to each other? What is their relationship? Or we can do the systemic anatomy, which is actually what we do in this course. And the systemic anatomy is looking at body systems. And we're going to start doing that a little bit here in this video. When we talk about physiology, then this is the function or the job of those structures, right? So this is really looking at things like the chemistry of those organelles and of those cells and those chemical reactions. This is really looking at the physics of how do we get gases from the atmosphere into the body? How do those gases get dissolved into the bloodstream? And then how do those gases move from the bloodstream to tissues or from tissues to the bloodstream, right? So with physiology, we're really looking at the overall organizational job of the body. right? When we talk about physiology for our body systems, we're going to see this overarching theme of what's called homeostasis. And we'll have just a whole video dedicated to this particular idea. So we'll come back to it here in chapter one, and then it'll be something routinely that we talk about. Now you can imagine here that it's going to be important to have an understanding of both of these pieces. So to really have a good understanding about the body, we need to look at both the anatomy and the physiology of the body, right? When we talk about the body anatomy, we do want to look at the overall organization of life. And this is going to be true actually for all life on the planet. So not just humans, although that is the study for this particular course. So we'll see that to begin, we start with the smallest units. So we have subatomic particles at the very smallest. And these come together to make what we call atoms. And then the atoms come together to make what we call molecules. And then the molecules come together to make what we call organelles. And then those organelles come together to make what we call cells. And then the cells are coming together to make tissues. Tissues come together to make organs. Organs come together to make organ systems. And then the organ systems collectively make the organism. And then what we'll see is from there, we can look at the way the organism interacts with other organisms on the planet and both living and non-living factors. And so our book does this nice job of just saying, okay, from the organism, we can start reaching out into the whole biosphere. So the biosphere is really talking about everything collectively on planet Earth. As we look at this list, we'll see that the subatomic particles, atoms, and molecules are all going to make up what we can call the chemical level. So we do have a little bit of a study of chemistry as part of our conversation about the human body. And then we'll see that the cell is this smallest living, and that's the key word there, unit. So the cell is going to be the level where all of the basic processes of the body are taking place at the cellular level. And so again, as part of our study of anatomy and physiology, we have to look at this microscopic unit of the cell. And that can be challenging because we don't have a lot of frame of reference for that. You know, we kind of have some ideas about the heart or the stomach or the brain. And the cell, unless you've studied it, is something that's very new. So we're going to be taking a look at that in a lot of detail as we go through the course. And then as we talk about tissues, we'll see that the human body has four categories of tissues. So we're going to have epithelial tissues. We're going to have connective tissues. We're going to have muscle tissues. And we're going to have neural tissues. And so all of the tissues of the body can be divided into one of these four categories. When we think about epithelial tissue, we should think about this is tissue that is going to be a lining for the body. So we're going to see it lining the very outside of the body. So our outer layer of skin here is made of epithelial tissue. And then the lining of the inside is also epithelial tissue. So in my mouth, the whole inside of my mouth is going to be lined with epithelial tissue. The whole digestive tract, right? So that would be my esophagus, my stomach, my small intestine, my large intestine, rectum, and anus would all be lined with epithelial tissue. Any kind of gland, organ, and so forth, blood vessel is going to be lined with epithelial tissue. your connective tissues are going to be, let's just call them here, like our supporting tissues. So they're going to fill in the gaps and the spaces. They're going to help support the rest of the body. They're going to help actually connect the body together. So that's a good name for that category. Your muscle tissue is going to be responsible for production of movement in the body. So this can be either like the whole body. This can be your smooth muscle of your organs. This can be the cardiac muscle of your heart. And then neural tissue, we'll talk about this as involved in communication. Okay. And we'll be talking about these four tissues in a whole lot more detail as we move into the lecture component. All right, y'all, that's it for this video. Stay tuned for our next video, continuing the discussion of how the body is organized, looking at the 11 body systems. And as always, take care of yourselves and each other.